with so local government in this map and by Iwate Prefecture. And outside of this line, controlled by the so local government. In this case, it's also Iwate Prefecture. And next slide here. So implementing a so TAF need a so rule. The rule discussion in the so special committee for fisheries management. The among the so representative from the fisher, distributor, local government officer, and the local government fish researcher. And not only this so special committee for fisheries management, there is also another committee for fisheries management in Japan. The national policy is also Fishery Policy Council, and adjacent to prefecture's policy, so Wide Sea Area Fisheries Adjustment Commission. And so local government policies, so Area Fisheries Adjustment Commission, and so FCA policy, this, and Fisheries Group policy. So anyway, there is so six commission in the so Japan for fisheries management and another so rules for fishing. And anyway, I would like to the so focus on the so special committee of fisheries management using the so next slide. So special committee for fisheries management. So at first, so prefecture so researcher gives the information regarding so actual resource condition, recommendation rule for fisheries management to the so member of the so committee. And anyway, so researcher explain about the information. And so member and so researcher discussion on the so this information. And after that, so they try to the, so making a rule, example was a guideline of fisheries management for a fish. And if the so making a decision for the so guideline of the so fisheries management, in this case, so move to the another phase, another step. So the member of the so committee representative in the fishing village. So the member explain about so this guideline of fisheries management to the so fishermen in the village. And everybody so discussion about so this explanation. Then after that, making a so decision regarding this discussion, and so after that, so making a so guideline of the so fisheries management for a fish, and after this, so move to the so next phase, next step, and step up. Finally, so the guideline move to the so exercise rule for fisheries light. It is so rule for TAF, a territory use light for fisheries. It's also rule for TAF. And the researcher is very important for the so making a decision for the fisheries management. So for example, local governmental fisheries exploration station. The researcher conducted the so survey on the so size and the weight of the so target species for the so fisheries management in a wholesale market, and they sometimes use the so the survey boat to collecting the data in the so the fishing ground, and so after that. So they adding so many data into the so this collected data, and after that so analyze so CBOE and stock assessment, and so they calculate so MSY and etc. And so the researcher not only focus on the so resource survey, but also the so economic survey. So the governmental official experimental station conducted so economic survey too. So the researcher collecting the data regarding the price and so size and the need or something in the so wholesale market and so urban area or something. Then after that, so they adding the so many data into the so collected data. After this, so they calculated so what size is the best price for the selling, and what size is the best for the so resources, so sustainable resources or something. So anyway, so this survey find out the so marketing strategy. Shared profit and so sustainable resource use. That is the so main purpose of this survey. And I can show you the so a case of the so exercise rule for fisheries like fisheries so light. This is also very important for the so tariffs. So anyway, tariffs. What to say? So the tariffs. So it's almost a tough equal the so exercise rule for fisheries light exercise rule. And so this exercise rule for fisheries light down the so like this. So for example, so input control, and sometimes so light down the so the rule protected area, and some rule is an input control. For example, this is a so cannot catch the so under the 30 centimeter Japanese flounder, and so 20 centimeter marble sole, and etc. And sometimes also regulated so limited boat size as a 10 ton for gillnet or something. And this is so technical control, especially this rule focus on the so mesh size or something. And finally, so this so rule have the so penalty rule. Anyway, this is also administered rule. And anyway, this is so outline of the so rule for the so technical. I'm sorry, rule for the so tough or something. And next so stage is also a mechanism for the keeping fisheries management rule by fishers. So I explain outline of the so fisheries management system in Japan using so slides. And so big problem or interest is how to administrate fisheries management rule by fisher. So why do the so fishers follow the so exercise rule? The rule is so criteria which a local government allowed, but the so rule were decided by themselves after many so discussion among fisher with local governmental officers and researchers. That's why so they conducted mutual monitoring on violate rules. So many fishermen live in the so fishing village for a long time. and will continue to live there. So it is very important to maintain harmonization among fishing villagers in the sub-village. Therefore, it is difficult to violate the rule. It means the ostracism. And next is this result from the very famous academic paper, Nature. So successful fisheries were promoted by the leadership and social capital and incentive. So anyway, I would like to focus on the leadership using the next slide. So Japan has a leader of the fisheries system. The Japanese name is Gyugyoshi. So the leader, so recommended by the Fisheries Cooperative Association and Fisheries Extension Officers. After this, Gifu gave an honor title by governor. And the leader take a training course as a leader. And they collect information of the outside and learn new technology from the outside. And furthermore, they work as an advisor in their fishing village to implement the latest technology, new technology, and teach from the developed area, such as new fisheries management rule with a success story and etc. And they attend the committee of the leaders. And this system has two layers. So one layer is a senior fisheries leaders group. They focus on the general matters. And the second layer is a young fisheries leaders group. They focus on the new technology and the latest fisheries management and success story and etc. So that is a legal system in Japan. And then next is a monitoring control surveillance system. So Japanese monitoring control surveillance system has three layers. One layer is national level, coastal guard, and the second level is prefectural level. In this case, it's Iwate Prefecture. Iwate Prefecture have two local governmental seats like this. This is a control surveillance board. And furthermore, the Fisheries Cooperative Association have the surveillance board over the tail. And the next early stage is surveillance fisher. And the total number of the surveillance fisher is 251. And the total number of the household is 5,000. So that's why the 20% fishermen is a surveillance fisher. So this is a formal organization. And this is an informal group or organization, monitoring by the ordinary fishermen themselves. So it's also mutual check, and also monitoring in wholesale market. So the officer checking the illegal fish or not, and they find the illegal fish, so the officer. So ask to the Fisheries Cooperative Association and member of the surveillance fisher or something. So that is Japanese monitoring server control and surveillance system. And next is fisher's motivation to comply with the fisheries management. So the fishermen usually can get the technical information from the fisheries extension officer. And so subsidy, get the subsidy. And sometimes also get the license, prefecture license, and the utilization of a fishing port and the space around the port. And so they can get the fisheries cooperative association license for aquaculture, given cage, long line, etc. And can get the small loan and a small debt from the fisheries cooperative association. And they can use the shared facility for sure. And they can sell the marine product to the wholesale market. So it is a motivation to fisher to comply with the fisheries management. If they break the rule, it is difficult to use this subsidy or license or loan or something. So that's a very important motivation for the issues. And next is a cut. So I have also only remains 4 minutes. So that's the final slide. So mechanisms for the complying with the issue. At first, it's a conclusion. At first, so many fisher anyway violate so fisheries management rule because of the making of money. And but so authorization pressure to the violating fisheries management rule by fisher. And the second is fisheries leaders group, as you gosh, pressure to the violating fisheries management rule. And it is also big pressure to the violating. So I already explained about the monitoring surveillance control system. And FCA license and the law and debt and etc. And the local governmental license, technical information, subsidy, etc. So pressure to the violating fisheries management rules. And finally, so success, it's a hope, not a pressure, it's a hope. The hope is a success story of the fisheries management. Also outside of the fishing village. It's my presentation file, and it's done. Thank you for your attention. And let's develop small-scale fishing village and secure seafood. Thank you.